any individual. It is my pleasure, I am humbled, I am honored to bring to you someone I call my friend, Mr. David Banner.
Couple things. For those who don't know me, I think I have a Grammy. Sometimes I say I do, sometimes I don't. I produce from Justin Bieber to Wayne to Chris Brown. A lot of people. I'm an actor. People say that I'm an activist, but I don't like the title because I do for my community what an alpha male is supposed to do for his community. So I don't want that credit. But listen to me. I want to first say something about Miss Washington before I start my proposal. She can run, she can go nowhere with it. I don't mean in a sexual way. I don't mean in a get married way. But I fell in love with this woman from the first time I ever heard her speak. And when I heard her speak, she was speaking about you all. Her passion about what you all have to go through. When she was speaking and she spoke at this teacher's convention in Mississippi. And you know how you see old footage of Dr. Martin Luther King and Malcolm X and all of those types of people in it? It makes you feel like something is in your throat or in your heart. When she was talking about what you all have to go through every day. Come on, come help me. Sure? Good. Make sure. I'd never seen that in my generation. And we became friends. And I'm actually thinking about writing a book about the stuff she tells me about you all's experiences. It's gonna be called Door to Door. It's gonna be about what kids from New York, LA, Chicago, New Orleans, and Miami, what children have to go through from the time they leave their house and to the time they make it to the door at the schools. And the time that they leave the door at the schools until they make it back home. They never give you all that kind of consideration of what's my tone of language, Ms. Washington?
Keep it clean.
Clean? Like, is PG, is that totally clean? Or? So is it? Y'all gotta go through. From the time that y'all leave, you know what I'm saying? From the time that y'all leave y'all home and to the time that y'all get to school. So, one of the things that I wanna do is I wanna tell y'all a little bit about me, and then I wanna talk about your responsibility. And then I want most of the time to be you all asking me questions. Because so many times grown-ups talk at you all, but they don't listen. And people don't know what you're going through. So I may be talking about something that you may not be interested in or something that may not affect your personal life. So most of the stuff I want to talk about is directed, is or going to be directed at you all's questions. But for 5 minutes, can I talk to the grown-ups? Can I talk to the grown-ups? So, hold on, y'all stay there. So I want the grown-ups to know something. They talk so much about these children being a lost generation, and I don't believe that to be true, but if they are a lost generation, it's because you ran off and left them. Our children are a direct reflection of what we did or did not do. I give you an example. When we look at the new rappers, and the new rappers are all about the money, the reason why they're all about the money is because my generation told them money over everything. So when these kids only want to get the bag, it's because that's what I told them and that's what I showed them. So that is why it is my responsibility to come back and undo some of the damage. I'm not talking about no other rapper. I'm talking about what I did. So it's my responsibility to make it better. So in most cases, I was talking to my circle that I had this morning, and I know some of y'all may get mad, but I even talked about the zero tolerance laws that they have in all these black schools. How in the hell you gonna put these kids back out on the streets? You got an all male school and you don't think these kids are gonna fight? All this testosterone? You're a fool if you think that. And if you throw them back to the streets, where are they gonna learn how to manage or deal with that anger and aggression? And it's better to keep them here and show them something. Now, if they draw some blood or really hurt somebody, I get that. But this is the microcosm of the world that these kids are supposed to learn how to be a human being. Y'all try to keep them in this so-called perfect environment when you know the police don't whoop their ass outside. You know gangs and violence don't give a damn about authority. So how are they supposed to learn how to navigate through the real world if you put them in an artificial bubble? I think that's sad. And I also think that in so many cases, we forget how grown-ups used to treat and teach us. I'm gonna be very honest with you. When I was young, I used to love the preacher's daughters. Because none of the preachers really thought their daughters were doing nothing, and they wouldn't teach them nothing, and we would run them through the hood. Ain't that right, boys? So listen. In closing with the grown-ups, these are our children. When I see our children, I see God. It's just that they lost our way and we're gonna have to spend a little bit more time. Deal? Alright, see y'all. Listen, focus. It's not fair, but when you deal with some of those grown-ups, and I told my group this today, so y'all bear with me. A lot of these grown-ups, not all of them, they ain't nothing but big kids. And sometimes a lot of them are not right. But in order for you all to navigate yourself through life, you're gonna have to deal with them. Some of them, not all, some of them are jealous of you because they are stuck in wherever they are in their life and you still have infinite potential. And the sad thing about it is some of the mistakes that they make in your life or to your life can derail everything that you do in life, ever. So understand, come on, we're talking. Who? You? Come on, bro. Let me tell you something real quick. It's on real, it's on everything that I love. If you don't want to be here, leave. I'm gonna tell you why. I'm a businessman. I get paid $10,000 every, at least 10, anywhere from $10,000 to $350,000 every time I speak. You know how much I got paid to be here? Chicken salad. It was awesome chicken salad, but it wasn't a $10,000 salad. So what I need you to do for me is to respect my time, because when you talk or not talk, that means you're chumping me, and I'm not like a chump type dude, and I'm not like a teacher, so I get emotional, and I don't have the same restraints that they have. So please just respect me. Hey, don't talk while I talk, and if you want to talk, I'll give you the mic, and then it'll be cool. Deal? Thank you. Quick question. You got those three questions for me? No, you give them to me and I'm gonna pick which ones I want. Alright, I'm gonna keep talking until we get it. Alright. Where was I? What was the last thing to say? That was before the chicken salad, because that's what it railed me. Like, where was I going?
We ain't going to
That's after I leave. Everybody, oh, the adults are jealous of y'all. Right, okay, let's get back to that. So listen, one of the things that I told my group, and this is not fair, I know based on where you go to school, how much money most of your family makes. Because they grew, especially black and Latin descended people in the same places on purpose. So I know about the median income that most of your parents make. So I need you to start thinking about school this way. It's your life and it's a business. If your parents or your family is in a certain situation, it is your responsibility to make it better. Because the truth is, most people who are my age, they're done. You have an opportunity to make it better. This is your school. I was telling my circle, like, I'm not one of these cats that's gonna tell you not to fight. I'm not one of these cats that's gonna not tell you not to have fun. I'm not gonna tell you all that, but what I will tell you, if anybody you should fight, it shouldn't be anybody in this school. If it's gonna be a gang, it's gonna be Eagle Academy. It's gonna be the people who are around you. They have fooled us so much. My homeboy stay in Tam Projects. I used to stay on 118th in Madison. I stayed up there for like 6 years. I remember Jim Jones from Tam. It's at the situation now, they done fooled y'all so much that y'all killing people that stay right across the street from you. Harlem's killing Harlem folks. Folks from Brooklyn is killing folks from Brooklyn. Bloods is killing Bloods, and Crips is killing Crips. Like, it don't even matter no more. We just killing ourselves, right? So what I'm learning as far as education is concerned is information is the only thing that can free you. It's what you know. Have y'all ever noticed how many rappers y'all see that make all of this money and literally 5 years later they broke? You know why they broke? Because they don't know how to do nothing, or they don't know anything but rapping. They don't know nothing about the publishing. They don't know nothing about BMI. They don't know nothing about ASCAP. They don't know nothing about the fact that every contract you sign, that's why I tell people, like, you want to rap, but you don't want to go to school? Okay, cool, let me ask you a quick question. If you don't know how to read, how do you know what you signed? I remember I signed something in the contract, it said something about my likeness. The record company owned the way that I looked. I couldn't even sell a picture. They owned like my face, my facial recognition. Because I didn't know what likeness meant, not only did I sell it, I gave it away for free. I gave away my whole catalog. Most of us, we hurt so bad. If they give us, and let me tell you something about these record labels, if y'all want to be rappers, and this is in business in general. If somebody offers you a dollar, best believe you're worth three. I'll say that to you one more time. If someone offers you a dollar, you are worth how much?
Three.
So most of us, because we never had a dollar in our pocket ever, we'll sign anything for 50 cents. Literally, because we don't know any better. You got those questions? What do you think?
Okay, first one is.
Who? David who?
Hold on one second.
Y'all know who he was. You want me to give him the clue? Wait, hold on, stand up.
Say it one more time.
Stand up, hold on, stand up and give me his name.
What are you saying?
Huh?
What are you saying?
Say it again? All right, hold on. You know it? Huh? No, don't say nothing.
Jesse Jackson.
No, you can't say it, because if you say it and you ain't raise your hand, then you giving away the answer.
Movement and lawyer. He's also a freedom fighter and a legal representative for Malcolm X. He's the highest ranking African American elected official in New York City.
Hello? Stand up. Stand up. What's the name? Al Sharpton. No, sir. Yes, sir. Post his son?
Yes.
What you know. If you give your information out for free without being acknowledged, like let's say if I'm the boss and I'm paying you for your answer and you blurt it out without me acknowledging you, well, you just gave me the information for free. I ain't gotta pay you. You just gave your information away. Put your hand up, I have to acknowledge you. Listen. It is what you know that is actual freedom in America. It's not only what you know, it's how deep and how specific that information is. I gave the students in my circle this example. If you are a general doctor, you get paid general money. But if you are a brain surgeon and you have specific knowledge, then you get specific money, right? So when you look at your education, you have to look at your education the same way. I give you an example. I started being an actor, and I hated to read when I was in high school, couldn't stand the book. Now I have to read a script, and a script to a movie is the equivalent of a book. I have to read a whole book every day of my life, almost. And so I had to learn and teach myself to learn or love information again. I remember I got pulled over by a cop. I was telling him this too. And I'll be honest with y'all, I had been drinking. I ain't gonna lie to you, I was full of tea. But I understood my rights. And I told him, I said, I'll do your test, but you can't stick nothing in my mouth. You can't stick nothing in my arm. I'm not taking any breathalyzer. I'm just not. I found out in the state of Georgia, they can't force you to take a breathalyzer. And since I work out a lot and I had, was doing CrossFit, I knew how to center, get my body to center of gravity and sit down in the right place so I wouldn't fall and bust my ass, right? So he gave me that test two times, and I knew that he knew that I was drunk, but the fact that I understood my rights, I knew the law, and he knew he couldn't handle me any way he wanted to. So in most cases in America, the reason why black people or people of culture in general are still in captive or held in captive is because of our lack of information. We don't know our rights. We don't know our state representatives. We don't know who runs our neighborhood. We don't know any of those things. So we are victims to people who do know. You understand what I'm saying? And that's the reason why I do that. Because with your generation, and it started with mine, we don't want to hear no talk. A wise man said, you can't lead the people if you can't feed the people. So if you can't show these children a way to the bad, or you can't show them no money. They don't want, you notice how everybody stood up when I pulled out their bread? And that's one of the things that I want to tell the parents. I was telling the kids earlier, I don't agree with the suits and ties. I don't believe in kids having to be in uniform. And I'll tell you why. The only reason why we put our children in uniform is because we want them to go work for white people. We want them to go work for corporations. So we are teaching them to socialize. I run my own business. That's the reason why I can wear jeans. I don't have to comb my hair. Everybody in my office got on jeans, got locks and tattoos, because I hired them. As long as they have the information, as long as they are the smartest person in the building, this is the only thing that I care about. Because y'all know when you're dealing with them white boys who programming them computers, they don't care how them boys dress. They can come in there, code up, and do whatever else they want to, as long as you can program that computer. So at the end of the day, when I deal with these boys, I just need you all to get the information. The second thing I need you to do, and then after the third one, I'm gonna let y'all ask me questions. I need you all to protect the school. Something that we have stopped teaching you all as men is to be protectors. Miss Washington shouldn't have to walk down the hall and pick up no sheet of paper with your young, strong self. She shouldn't have to open the door. I told her that when she was walking today. I said, I know you ain't used to it because you used to being a leader, but you don't need to touch no doors when I'm around. I'm a man, I'm a gentleman. You don't have to touch them. Wasn't I walking through your halls picking up paper? She shouldn't, as a woman, she shouldn't have to touch anything. The thing about being a man and the thing about being an alpha male, everybody wants to be a man. Everybody wants to be an alpha male, but I saw a TED talk that changed my life. Do you know that there's responsibility that comes along with being a man? Do you know why men are usually stronger than women physically? Because it's your responsibility to protect God. Women reproduce. So while they are reproducing, it is your responsibility to protect them. If you are strong and you a man, that is part of your responsibility in that school, is to be strong. And should nobody come on this school, whether it's another teacher, another person, and disrespect these grounds. And it don't have nothing to do with the school itself, but we as black men or people of culture, we have to get back to protecting our tribe. One of the things that I was telling my circle today, if you good at math and the girls like him, well, usually if you good at the girls, you ain't doing much math because you're on the phone talking to the girls. So that means you need to teach him how to get the girls, and you need to teach him the math. It's like we gotta start helping each other. If you come from a family that's a little bit better off, but you can't throw them hands, then you need to make sure that your homeboys got a little bread, then you ain't never gotta worry about fighting. Because we are taking care of our community. Y'all real live need to protect each other until you die. Make Eagle Academy a cult. If you end up getting a job, or you end up being a boss later on, as long as they got the right information, should nobody from Eagle Academy have to worry about a job. Those are the things that we have to get back to doing. The third thing. I need y'all to do me a favor, this is very important. Figure out what your mission statement is. Figure out what you want to do in life. The reason why it's so easy for people to manipulate us, because most of us really don't know what we want. Most folks want to be rappers because they think it's easy. And they really don't want to work in school. They want to be rappers, but they don't want to tour. They don't want to add. They want to be rappers that go on tour, but don't even know how to read a map. And one dude told me today when we were sitting in her office, he was like, well, why do I have to read a map? Why do I know how to add if I got a phone? Great question. What if the folks decide they don't want some people to have phones no more? I was in New York. Y'all made me too young. Were y'all old enough when New York had the blackout? I was in New York when the blackout happened. And those people who didn't know how to navigate themselves, and people who didn't know how to cook, and people who didn't know how to walk, they were slaves to the people who knew how to. You are a slave to whatever you don't know. So as much information as you can get, I stopped collecting J's. To be honest with you, y'all really the only reason why I still wear Jordan.
He got the ones feet right now.
Cause Michael Jordan personally don't do nothing for our community. And, but not just Michael Jordan, none of the shoe colors. I only made Jordan an example because Jordan is a shoe that I like the best. But the reason why I still buy Jordan is because I had a brother and he's giving it to a black face. Because people say, why you keep putting Jordans on if you don't like Jordan? At least it goes to one black family. It may not go to 10 or 20, but at least if I give it to Jordan, it'll go to somebody, maybe one of his kids to do for our children or something. Or maybe one of y'all can date one of his daughters or something and get some out of the Eagle Academy in the building one way or another. That was sort of a sexual joke. Don't worry about that. Y'all too young for that. But, listen, now we're going to go to the question part. Listen to me. Look at me. You can just, hold on, man. Hold on a second. Hold it.
Wait for a minute, man.
So what I'll ask is this. I want one of you all, in case some of you have to leave when my question and answer part going, I want one of you all to ask a question. Just one. And then the rest of y'all can ask later. Anybody? Yes, sir.
Here, tell me your name, stand up, tell me where you're from.
My name is Devon Thomas, and I wanted to know what type of business
you
well, I'm not, but I do live.
I think what you see stay in the neighborhood. Hey, hood means neighborhood.
Oh.
I want
to know what your business actually does.
Okay, he wants to know what my business does. I own a, listen, look at it, ask a question. I own a multimedia company. I score movies, video games, commercials. I did the second biggest Gatorade commercial in history. I did music for Mercedes-Benz, Gillette, Kmart. I did music for The Wire, Marvel vs. Capcom, Sony. Basically, I provide vision for companies and tell them what's cool a lot of times. Man, like, to be honest with you, I'm not joking. I get paid around like $2,500 a minute sometimes. I mean, just because of what I know and my experience and the things that I've been around and the people that I know. That's another thing that's really important that your generation is gonna have to learn is people need to like you. Get to know people, speak to people. You understand what I'm saying? Shake a hand, all right? My name is David Dunn. I don't care what you think.